Namaste everyone, myself is Sarika Reddy and today I am going to take second part of our geography chapter from class 8th. Okay, what is the name of the chapter? The name of the chapter is Land, Soil and Water, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife. Okay, so this is our second chapter and we have studied part first of this chapter. Means half of the chapter I have already explained you in my previous video. So now I am continuing with the remaining portion of the chapter. Okay, so in the last part what we have discussed different methods or different ways through which the quality of the soil got degraded. Okay, and what are the reasons of this? The reasons of these are, first one is deforestation. जब हम trees को cut करते हैं तब इसके बाद में overuse of chemicals, soil erosion, floods, these are the basic reasons why soil got degraded. Now we are going to study about methods of soil conservation. So here are some methods through which we can conserve our soil. And what are those methods? Number one, first method is mulching. Actually, what do you mean by mulching? Mulching जो है किसी भी surface के ऊपर, when we are spreading a thatch or grass over a particular layer of the soil regain its moisture. In that way the quality of soil will be regained. In this way we are practicing mulching. Okay, next one is so mulching is spreading of thatch like stuffy objects on the top layer of the soil. In this way the soil regain its moisture and we can conserve our soil. Okay, second is contour barrier. Contour barrier means wherever the place is there where there is a possibility that water will flow away or water will flush away the soil of the top layer of the soil. In that way what we are doing? In these we are growing some grass over there so that the flow of water will not stop and the water got collected at a particular place. In this way this method is known as contour barriers. Okay, next is rock dam. Rock dam means we are collecting the small pieces of stones and we are arranging in such a way so that the water will not flow away. In that way rock dam is also another system. Next is terrace farming. Terrace farming especially it is practiced in the mountainous region. The slopes of the mountain will cut down in the structure of steps so that the plain surface will be utilized for the cultivation purpose. This method is known as terrace farming. When we are doing cultivation in such a way, we are able to conserve our soil also because soil will not flow away. Okay, next is intercropping. Intercropping means when we observe any field, what type of texture we are observing, that we are observing row of all the crop. So ek line bani rehti crops ki. So what we are doing? We are interchanging after a particular season. So intercropping pattern means during one season we are growing the seeds or sowing the seeds in a particular row. In another season we are sowing the seeds in a different row. In this way intercropping is also one of the method to conserve our soil. Next is contour plugging. Contour plugging means that particular area by the edges of the field grass will be grown so that the water will not moved away, and in this way when water got collected it absorbed by the soil and in this way the moisture of the soil will be regained. In this way contour plugging will be practiced. Last one is shelter beds. Shelter bed, this type of soil conservation is practiced especially where heavy wind is blowing or wind is blowing very fast in those regions. So what happened? Sometimes you may observe that when you are moving and towards any road, so you may observe that row of trees were there in such an area. So those row of trees are known as shelter belts. It means that the trees are stopping the sand particles to move from one place to another. So this method is also used. So in this way we can conserve our soil. Okay, now move to next resource. Next resource is water. We have already discussed in our first chapter that water is very important resource. It is called renewable resource also. And why it is renewable resource? Because it got recharged in the form of rainfall. the water bodies, water contained in the sea, lake or oceans, it got evaporated and then again coming back to earth in the form of rainfall. In this way, the process of water cycle goes on and it should be renewed. So in this way, we can say that water is a renewable resource. Next, how we can conserve our water? Conserve. How it is practiced? When we are using afforestation method, means forestation means if we are going to trees, in that way soil water will be regained. Okay, and next one is less use of chemicals, fertilizers. So this also helps in the conservation of water also. So this is the next part of our chapter. Okay, now we should move on to our next topic, that is natural vegetation. Okay, so natural vegetation means the all the trees, plants, grasses which are available in nature, that all are included in natural vegetation. Okay, so first we are going to discuss about what type of natural vegetations are there in on the earth. So there are four types of natural vegetation which is found on the earth. And what are those? First one is forest. Okay, forest, there are two types of forest. First is evergreen forest and second is deciduous forest. As it is already known by its name, evergreen forest. Wherever we are finding evergreen forest, the trees remain green for whole season. What is the reason? Because they are shedding their leaves at a particular time. But this shedding should be one by one. So they are not shedding the tree, their leaves all together. So the trees remain green forever. That is why the name of the typical forest is evergreen forest. Next is deciduous forest. Deciduous forest are those forests which are having specific season in which they shed their leaves. In this way, under natural vegetation, first type is forest, and in forest we are observing two types of forest. First one is evergreen and second one is deciduous forest. Now move to next part, that is grassland. Grasslands are, you have observed grasses on the surface of the soil, so that is grassland. But grassland also includes stunted trees. These short sized trees also are included in grassland. So this is the second type of vegetation. Next is scrubs. Scrubs, actually these are the vegetation which are basically grown in the low rainfall area or in the desert area. And why they are grown over there? Because these type of trees are suitable for the desert area or the area where less rainfall occurs. Okay, so what are the situation in which they are able to survive in low rainfall region area? Because their roots are very very long or large, so they stuck to the underground water, they stretch to the underground water level, and in that way they fulfill their need of water. Okay, and less amount of water got transferred during this leaves, so due to its leaves, and in this way scrubs are able to survive. And in this way, this is also another type of vegetation. Now fourth is tundra vegetation. Tundra vegetation is available in the polar regions where too much cold weather is there, too much cold atmosphere is there. In such a type of areas, the vegetation we observe is tundra vegetation. Okay, so in this way we can say that natural vegetation are of four basic types. What are those? Number one is forest, and under forest we are observing two examples, evergreen and deciduous. In grassland, these are very short in size. Scrubs are found in the low rainfall area, and tundra vegetation is found in polar regions. So this is all about natural vegetation. As we have to save our soil, we have to conserve our soil, we have to conserve our water, in the same way we have to conserve our natural vegetation as well as wildlife also. I have already told you that conservation of soil, conservation of natural vegetation, conservation of water cycle, wildlife is also important. Why it is important? Because they are very helpful in renewing or continuing our cycle of the living beings or human beings as well as other living creatures on the earth. So it is our prime responsibility that we have to conserve it. So we are taking initiative, we are conserving at our level, but apart from it, government is also taking several initiative. Government is organizing various programs. For example, Van Mahotsav is also there, that is celebrated that because they are giving us message that how we have to save the environment, how we have to save our natural vegetation and wildlife also. So in countries like India, we are organizing, and that is in the form of Van Mahotsav. But at the international level also, we are trying to save our natural vegetation as well as wildlife also. And how it is initiated? It is initiated in the form of CITES, C-I-T-E-S. CITES, actually it is a short form of an international convention. And what does it includes? It includes the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna. Means it is an international convention which is taking initiative to save our natural vegetation as well as wildlife also. So in this way, this is all about our chapter, and I think that you must understood this chapter, and I want that all of you should take initiative to save our soil, to save our natural vegetation, to save water, to save wildlife, flora and fauna also. Okay, this is all about our chapter. Thank you.